time we had seen the definition of Atmanubhava as given by who? Shankaracharya. And this Atmanubhava takes place or can take place in Nirvikalpa Samadhi, which was described based on the three mantras from Kathopanishad, second chapter, third vandi, nine, ten, mantra. In this state, the five sense organs are not indulging in their sense objects. That is, plus mind also. Five indriya, jnana indriyas along with the mind are withdrawn from the vishayas. Buddhishcha vicheshtati.
Buddhi also what? Doesn't function. Buddhi functions in terms of what? Vrittis.
Free from that. Is battery all right? The buddhi also is not functioning. And this was stated as most exalted state. Stated as what? Most exalted state. Wherein it is a means to experience Atmananda, Brahmananda. It is a means to experience Atmananda, Brahmananda. This mind is free from all vrittis. And indriyas, mana, buddhi. Indriyas, the mind and buddhis are what? Nirvyaparani. Free from their vyapara. What is a vyapara? What our vyapara? Functions. Free from their functions. What is our vyapara? Local language. Trade. Business. Trade is called vyapara. Actually, it is originating from activities only. Activities only. So here, they have withdrawn from their corresponding this functions. And it says, this is the Atmanandasya Bhanasya Sadhana Bhutam. You can experience here in this state Atmananda, Brahmananda. Those who say Brahmananda is the highest non-experiential ananda, please note, make a note of this. Okay, this is what the Kathopanishad has to say. In fact, Vidyaranya Muni has pointed out, in this state of mind, Brahmananda can be experienced. Who is Vidyaranya Muni? Not a, come on, tell me. What not a? Not a lip Vedanti, okay? Shankaracharya is not a lip Vedanti, okay? So that's why he says, see, there is the one, I told you the one prayer is that. That is Brahma Vidashirvada Padhati. Beautiful this Achkari. It is meant to sing the blessing of a Brahmanyani, but entire Vedanta is contained in that. So where you can experience Brahmananda, it says like this. Say, what is that? Yasmin Kale, Should I tell the meaning?
Yes.
At what time? That is the advantage of being born in India, okay? Yasmin kale, at when? Well, at what time? Dvaita bhanam nasti. Understood? Perception of dualistic world is not there, number one. Nidra api na agachati. You are not sleeping also. You are not sleeping also. Nidra api na agachati. If your mind has accomplished these two conditions, says, tasmin kale, at that time, upalabhyamanam yat sukham. Upalabhyamanam is a perceived, means what? Experience. Whatever happiness experience with two conditions. What are two conditions? Dvaita bhana is not there. Sleep is not there, my dear sir. Saha brahmananda. That's what Ananda, Brahmananda, experiential or not? Or we have to say what? Vidyaranyam didn't know. Veda. Thappadu Veda. If you open the mouth like that, in front of you, those who know Vedanta, you'll get those. Dharmandi again says at other place, when this is accomplished, asangoham, I am asanga. See, I told you other day, when you say, I am happy, I am sorrowful, I am hungry, I am angry, first what? Experience or first knowledge or what? First comes what? Experience. Then comes the knowledge. Unless I experience, I am hungry. Hunger, I can't say I am hungry. Unless I experience sorrow, I can't say I am sorrowful. Knowledge, decision is there. But something I experience. Like that, my children, they cry. Why they cry? The mother knows. The hunger. That child doesn't know if there is a hunger. But afterwards, after growing up, it will come to know. So that's for that. So therefore, asanga literally means I am totally unconnected. Unconnected to what? Presently, what are you connected with? Upadis. Upadis. Total lack of connectivity with the connectivity. What are the word? Internet connectivity. So therefore, total lack of connectivity with what? The body, the sangha. Experience or not? Sangoham means I am upadhi rahita. When you say upadhi rahita, please tell me in the language of Mandukya Mantra 7, what does it mean? Antaprajna is not there. Vaishprajna is not there. All varieties of prajnas are not there. In short, Vishwa is not there. Taijasa is not there. Prajna is not there. What is there? Sahatma Sahavinaya. Atma remains. Atma only remains or not. So that's it. That is what? Chidatma aham. I am Chaitanya Swarupa. Iti so pratyagatmani niveshite. When the mind is pratyagatmani niveshite, you may not know the word niveshite, sakshatkrute. Mind is what? It is Brahma Chinmatra Swarupa. Chaitanya and Chaitanya alone is there, nothing else is there. There is Niveshite. Yet if you are still not clear, Vidyarani helps you. How? Vritti Rahite. No vrittis. You heard this Kathopanishad, Nirvikalpa Samadhi, no vrittis. Vritti rahite. Then, what about antakkarana? Samskara matrataya sukshma rupena avasthite chitte. Chitta is that how? In samskara form. What samskara form? Only the, that is what? Residual form. That's why I say, some people say, see, you cannot have a state totally free from duality because in Nirvikalpa Samadhi also, vrittis are there, chitta is there, accepted. We are not bothered about that. We are talking of practical condition and not theoretical aspect. This, what vrittis are there in Nirvikalpa Samadhi? Deyakara vritti. Deyakara vritti are what? Atmakara vritti and samskara shesha. If antakarana is not there in residual form, where are you going to have Nirvikalpa Samadhi? How are you getting connected to your body? You will be snapped off from the body, then what? Pushimanabhu. Because such a person is Mahatma. When Mahatma leaves the body, it is not a time to what? Mourn, it's the time to rejoice. Like that. So you see, what is the context? If chitta chitta in the form of residual samskara is not there, body will snap up, celebrate. So that it cannot. See, it is necessary. Sabhasantakarana. To the minimum degree of its function, not vrittirahita, etc., is necessary. That's it. In that, whatever chitte, atmanaha swarupa bhutam anandaha avirbhavati. The swarupa bhutananda, paramananda, brahmananda gets revealed. Experiential or not? Fine? Theek. Now, our discipline. We have come to a stage of that Nirvikalpa Samadhi. We have convinced the first analysis, the study. And we have described this, the three mantras of Katha, how it shows as well. This state was pointed out by who? Bhashyakara is what he said was अविद्याध्यारोपण वर्जितः स्वरूप प्रतिष्ठा आत्मा. In this, it is Atma
free from what?
The all upadhis. Atma free from all upadhis. Is available in this. Means, where Atmanubhava is possible, in this state only the Atmanubhava is possible. This state, referring to these three mantras of Kathopanishad, is referred to by Vidyaranya Muni in Jivan Mukti Viveka, describing this is the state which is free from laya, vikshepa, kashaya, that is what it says, laya, vikshepa, the kashaya, and also sukhasvadana. What is that? Wait. Chapter 3, Manda Karikas 42 to 45 will describe four obstructions in this state wherein the Atma can reveal in its own sarupa. One is laya. Laya means sleep. Vikshepa, agitation. Then kashaya. What is kashaya? Kashaya, kashaya. Not kashaya, okay. Kashaya. What is kashaya? We know that. Decoction is called kashaya. Decoction is called. But what is this? The kashaya here. Kashaya here is what? Bahirmukha samskara. Samskaras the latent impressions in the mind which throw your mind external. Those samskaras which make your mind external are called kashayas. That one. Then rasasvadana. Rasasvadana means he is experiencing ananda. And what is that? Oh, not bad. I am able to know what. Get my mind absorbed where? In Atma Swarupa. I think I have progressed. I have progressed. Don't go on analyzing like this. You know what I mean? You are, that is what, reviving the ghost of ahankara. Ahankara, identity body is not getting revived, no. Nisangaha, pragnaya bhave, asanga, you be indifferent about that experience. This is the state who says the Vidyarana Munisis. And then Gaudapada says, that is the state wherein Brahma Nishpanna. Brahma Nishpatti is there. Nishpatti means Prapti. Prapti. That is why, make a note of this, I will be referring back when chapter 3, 46 verse prepared with the 42 to 45. This is what he is required then. This is what is required. So now, tell me, in this state wherein none of these prajnas are there, none of the Vishwartaisa prajna is there, is that, and what Bhashyakara says, Swarupa Pratishtha Atma, is it not Kriya? Of course, word Kriya is not even there, but what is used there is what? Chaturtha Atma.
Chaturtha
Atma. That is the ritual. This means so, now come on, tell me, what makes this Turiya Atma free from all upadis, free from all vrittis, free from all prajnas, non-experiences? Have you understood why this question is asked? Do you know the reason why I asked this question? Why that Turiya Atma has become non-experiential? Why? These people only tell Atma is what? Anubhava Swarupa. What you mean by Anubhava Swarupa? Self-experiencing principle. Is it Kadachitka? At times, Anubhava. At times, not. Always, okay? It is always Anubhava Swarupa. Again, it is always, see, Nitya Nyakti Swarupa. Always self-knowing principle. See, don't distinguish. Anubhava is one thing, knowledge. When you say Atma is Anubhava Swarupa, one thing. Jnana Swarupa is one thing. Ananda Swarupa is third thing. Don't say. Anubhava Swarupa itself is Jnana Swarupa. Jnana Swarupa itself is what? Ananda Swarupa. Only three words, why? We have seen from three different standpoints. Mortality, satya mortality, inertness, anubhava, ignorance, knowledge, sorrow, ananda. But entity is one and the same. That which is anubhava, itself is knowledge, that itself is what? Ananda. There is no separate three aspects or three entities are not there. This means, see, what they do, you know,
we don't need
separate Atma Anubhava because we are always experiencing Atma 24/7. Yes or no? Right? But what are you experiencing? Please tell me. Are you experiencing Atma? Is it Atma Anubhava or Jiva Anubhava?
Jiva.
Is it Atmanubhava?
Or it is it Atmanubhava or Samsaranubhava? 24/7 you are experiencing truth, which on experience it is samsara. We are talking about Atmanubhava. It is not Atmanubhava. If Atmanubhava, it should be true to Atma. See, mango anubhava. Reward. You should have that experience of sweetness of the mango. You should have the experience of the fragrance of the mango. You should have the delight of the yellow color of the mango. Is it not? Then you can say what? Mango anubhava. Atmanubhava say what? Paramananda anubhava. Asanga anubhava. Upadhyaya are not there. Sorrows are not there. Is it 24/7? Is it that? Unless you are already lost in samadhi. Then put in 19 days, 19 or 20 days, mamla, matter of 20 days. Afterwards celebrate, okay. so that, and if that is the case, my dear sir, what may stop that anubhava swarupa? What may stop that Swayam Jyoti Swarupa? What may stop that Swaprakasha Nidhitya Dhyakti Swarupa Atma? Come on. On what basis is it? See, look. Atmanubhava is what? Itself is experience. All that you need to do is what all? Obstruct this anubhava. Come on, what all obstruct? All is prajna. Vishvatayasva prajna, anta prajna, bahi prajna, all is prajna. It has been removed where in the nirvikalpa samadhi. What remains is what? Atma. It cannot be. It cannot be there. But that is said. So that for this, still if you have got doubt, let us see what Upanishads say. Kathopanishad. Atma is defined as ajo, nitya, etc. One word is used there, if you want the reference. Kathopanishad, first chapter, second valli, 18th mantra. Atma is defined as vipaschit. Vipaschit. You know what is vipaschit? I don't know. I don't know means when I first came across the word vipaschit, I didn't know. I have to take help of what? Bhashya. Bhashya describes it as medhavi. Again, it is not a correct, not complete description. Further gives medhavi as a viparilupta chaitanya swabhava. Vipaschit means what? Chaitanya Swabhava. Nothing but Chaitanya nature. And what type of Chaitanya nature? Viparilupta. Never extinct. Means what does it mean? Atma is Nitya Chaitanya Swarupa. Never extinct. If extinct means what? Ceases to be there means what happens? What will come? Jadatva. If Atma is the Chaitanya, awareness principle, experience principle, knowledge principle, which is never extinct, on what basis you say Turiya is not experiential? But its nature is what? Experience, experience, experience. That is one thing. That this avipari-lupta, in most of the texts, in Anandashram book, there is a word avipari-pluta-chaitanya-svabhava. Only in Anandashram, avipari-pluta, there we have to say, means uncovered chaitanya, means నిరుపాధిక చైతన్యం. నిరుపాధిక చైతన్య నెవర్ ఎక్స్టెన్స్ ఆల్వేస్ ఎక్స్టెన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ అండ్ యు ఆర్ సేయింగ్ క్రియ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ కాంట్రడిక్షన్. యు ఆర్ స్టిల్ ఫర్దర్ బృహదారణ్యక 4:3:23 to 4:3:30 नहि द्रष्टु दृष्टे विपरिलोपः विद्यते. द्रष्टु कैन बी टेकन डिफरेंटली सीयर आल्सो वन सीयर. दृष्टे दृष्टि इज व्हाट सर्व साक्षी भूता दृष्टि चैतन्य आत्मा. इट्स विपरिलोप विपरिलोप विनाश न विद्यते मीन साक्षी चैतन्य कैन नेवर गेट डिस्टर्ब. वन मोर अदर वे यू कैन से द्रष्टु कैन बी टेकन द प्रमाता हु इज व्हाट कूटस्थ चिन्मात्र रूप अविकारी नॉन चेंजिंग चैतन्य ओनली इट्स विनाश डिस्ट्रक्शन इज नॉट देयर. व्हाट डज इट मीन आत्मा इज ऑल द टाइम चैतन्य स्वरूप ज्ञान स्वरूप अनुभव स्वरूप काम स्वरूप. हाउ डू यू से दैट तुरिया इज नॉट एक्सपीरियंस राम सेड. सो दैट इज अगेन देयर ऑफ दिस कटअपर सर अगेन आफ्टर वर्ड जस्ट टू देयर घात घात हु घाण मतलब वन इज फेदर एक्सेट्रा विच गो सम देन इन दिस अजो नित्य शाश्वतो यम पुराण इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ विपश्चित ओनली नित्य. व्हाट डज इट मीन नित्य ever exists. It doesn't cease to be there. So that being the case, so that is, it is what a contradictory statement that, and if still you insist, Turiya is non-experiential, then what will happen? You are starting a new andha parampara, unknowingly or unintentionally. Why I am using the word unknowingly or unintentionally, these people themselves will not accept that what? The Atma Swarupa to be not Chaitanya, Nitya Chaitanya will not be there. At times it what? It stops. They will not. Well, the teachers have to be very, very careful in such making statement. There's a saying, you know what is that? Says if one student is bad, one person is spoiled. If one teacher is bad, many are spoiled. Teachers have to be very, very careful before making such statement. You have to think twice about it. So that is there. That means the case, this drishti never ceases to exist. That means this separate experience is not necessary, or turiya is not experiential. These are not a statement based on proper this thing of the shastra. Otherwise, you will have to produce the proof from shastra. Here it is said what? आत्मानुभव इज नॉट नेसेसरी. इन फैक्ट पंचपादिका से इन परोक्ष ज्ञान ज्ञान इज पॉसिबल विदाउट अनुभव. ट्रू परोक्ष ज्ञान इन डायरेक्ट नॉलेज बट नॉट इन द अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. टू प्रोड्यूस वेर इट इज टोल्ड इन द शास्त्र नॉट ऑन हियर से. प्रॉब्लम्स आर बिकॉज ऑफ हियर से ओनली. यू हैव टू गो ऑन द शास्त्र. That is now, this Atma is what now? This is Alukta Druk. Elsewhere it is said, Alukta Chit Svabhavaha, Anubhuti Prakasha, chapter 7, verse 229. Anubhuti Prakasha, chapter 7, no, not 7, 17, chapter 17, not 7, 17 chapter, verse 229. Says Sakshi is alukta chit swabhava. Uchit swabhav is what? Never lupta. You know what is lupta? Gayab. Lupta means that gayab ho gaya. So never, Chaitanya Swarupa never gets lost. Never get lost. Gayab means? What is gayab? Disappearance means getting lost. We have to use such word because they convey more. Gayab ho gaya. Disappeared. Ambi Chaitanya tha. Just now it was there and it is there. It vanished. Now we'll proceed to few of the things of Atmanubhava which I had not covered last time. I took only the definition given by who? Bhashyakara Shankaracharya, and give you detailed description as to where exactly Atmanubhava is possible based on the Kathopanishad 3 mantra. Now, few other things about this Atmanubhava need to be taken into account. So, what is that? Let us see. In Sutra Bhashya, I hope you know what is Sutra Bhashya? Brahma Sutra Bhashya. The first father, fourth sutra. Second sutra. 112. Not fourth sutra, not Samanvayadikarana. Second sutra. Anubhava avasanatva. Anubhava avasana, the famous statement. Buddha, that is what? Buddha vastvishatvacha brahma jnanasya. Brahma jnana has avasana. What is avasana? End, finale. Where? In anubhava. What anubhava? Brahma anubhava. Why so? Buddha vastvishatva. Brahma is an existent entity. Actually, I have clarified in my Brahma Sutra book, it is an answer to a Purapaksha of Puramimamsakas, Karmakandis, Jaimini Sutras. What they say, see, look, jnana you get by pramana or thought. Just a what is pramana? Jnana sadhana means of for any knowledge, pramana is necessary. Now, in the Karmakanda, there are many yajna yagas, the performance of which we have to know them. And if you afterwards you do that, you go ahead. What is your goal? What you want to experience? You would have skipped this sacrifice because you have to shed tears in front of this book. But without that you can't get it. Now look, when you study Karmakanda portion of the Veda, what is the Pramana? Veda. Veda tells, if you want to go to heaven, do this yaga. How this yaga is to be done? Like this. With the pramana, Veda. And when you study and get the knowledge as to how to do this thing, what is that? Experience is not there. Experience of what is not there? Heaven is not. And yet knowledge has taken place or not? You know exactly how to? Now in the case of Vedanta, tell me what is the pramana? Veda. Therefore, because Veda is the pramana, in Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana, experience is not this. It is a well tied up inference, anumana. Vyapti is given. Yes or no? You nod your head. Bhashyakara says no. By You have wrongly quoted. What is the negative? Tell me, in Karma Kanda, that knowledge you got, their experience of heaven is not there. Is it because Veda is the Pramana or your heavens are not at war? Your heaven, okay? Your heaven. Earned by you, ticket. So much of currency of punya already paid online. And the online ticket is there. Identity is there. Aadhaar card is there. Aadhaar card is there. So that is not there. Your heavens are not yet produced. That is what? That is why you are not able to experience. Not because of what? Vedas Praman. Say, in Atma, Brahma, Bhuta Vastu Vishayatvajya. Even when you are struggling to gain Atma Jnana, Atma exists, Brahma exists. So therefore, no, Bhashyakara dismisses that Upadhi. Upadhi means you are hetu you have given, the reason given, because Veda is Pramana, is fallacious argument. It is inapplicable. So this is how it is. Now, who says this? Bhashyakara. In fact, they teach Brahma Sutra, but never refer to this portion. Because you don't accept the Appam. Oh. Here again another problem. Someone said, you know, that Anubhava, word used in Vedanta, means knowledge. It has to be translated as knowledge and it should not be translated to us experience. Look, knowledge and experience. Knowledge and experience. In any language, whether you say Anubhava and Jnana, etc., they are semantically interconnected. You cannot totally distinguish on things. In certain things, you can be decisiveness is there in where? In the knowledge. Decisiveness may not be there in the, but wherever, we have seen this aspect already, yeah? I'm not going to repeat it. Wherever experience is possible, first experience, then direct knowledge. Without experience, indirect paroksha jnana is possible. This is what is there, therefore that is one thing. Now let us see what Vasishtha has to say about Atmanubhava Brahmanubhava. When you have Atmanubhava Brahmanubhava, you have no Anubhava of Jagat. When you have Anubhava of Jagat, there is no Anubhava of Atma Brahma. Says, Brahmatma Veti no Sargam Yoga Vasishta Nirvana Uttaradha 40, chapter 40, verse 9. Brahmatma, Atma here is what? Antakarna. The Brahma Jnani, whose mind is absorbed in Brahma, Sargam Vinaviti, he doesn't know experience what Sarga. Mind is, let's see, Brahmatma said because a Jivan Mukta at time may be aware of the, that is not the time. His mind is absorbed where? In the Brahma. He doesn't experience Jagat. Again, Sargatma. Who is Sargatma? We can also suppose Atma. Yeah, we are not Brahmatma, we are what? Sargatma is what? The person whose mind is preoccupied in the world, the Brahma Nauveti, He doesn't know Brahma. How is it so? An illustration is given. Sushupta veti nau swapnam. A sleeping person doesn't know swapna. Here can be dream or waking also. In the Karika Bhasha language, it is going to come. Swapnastha na sushuptakam. The one who is in the waking or the dream, he doesn't know sleep. So therefore, what? Both these cannot both exist. Then elsewhere he says, dvaita advaita yoho yugapad darshanasya asambhava. After this atman, I am going to take samadhi. Let me finish this portion. I will take the samadhi portion in detail, including in Bhagavad Gita, where all Bhagavan speaks of samadhi, where all Bhashyakara emphasizes the need of samadhi, for what purpose, all those things from the Shastri Bhasha, I am going to tell you. But before that, let me finish this Atman Bhava portion totally. So that dvaita advaita yoho yugapad darshanasya asambhava. Dvaita jagat, advaita brahma, simultaneously you cannot experience. Not that Brahma jnani hates dvaita. Don't think that way. He has no hate at all. They cannot coexist. That's what is not that Brahma jnani hate. They cannot coexist. In Panchikarna Vartika, Sureshwara Acharya says, Atmani eva arudha bhavaha jagat etan navikshati. A person who is absorbed in the Atma Sarupa doesn't perceive the jagat. That means, in Atma Anubhava, what is not there? Perception of jagat is not there at all. So that is the case. If you say Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana is understanding of Shastra, you are at what level? Purushana is true. You are at Bahish Prajna level. You are at Vishwa level. You are aware of the world. That is not Brahma Jnana, that is not Brahma Anubhava, that is not Atma Jnana, that is not Atma Jnana. One place, Shankaracharya, with sarcastic, said, I have told you 100 times. What is that? That is Brahma Anubhavarudam to Jnana Phalam. Result of Brahma Jnana is what? Anubhavarudam, Prapta Anubhavam, is the experience. I told you, look here. If last time you have forgotten, I know. Last time I told you, if Anubhava were what? To mean everywhere Jnana, why all Shastra, why all Bhashya, why all Tikas have to use the word Anubhava? They should use what? Jnana. Come on, what did I bring to your notice from Bhasha last time? Nahi varaghataya kanya udvahayanti. Parents do not get the daughter married to kill the son-in-law. In Kekha Bhasha Chakra, what for it is meant? To clarify you.
To clarify
what? Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. If Anubhava were to mean Jnana, why should they use Anubhava to confuse us? What is the purpose of Bhashya? What is the purpose of Tikas, glosses? What is it? To give clarity. Let's say, daughter is not got married to kill her. Sanjindha means your purpose itself is what? not serve, not only not serve, danger. That's why they will not there, let us not venture in such translation, such. Anubhavaruda praptam bhavantu jnanfalam. Means, result of Brahma Jnana is experiential. Yat sakshat aparokshat Brahma iti shruti. This phrase I have taken in detail. The Brahmadhanaka say, sakshat aparokshat. Sakshat aparokshat means sakshat aparokshat. That means what? Anubhava sarupa atma only, nothing short of that. We have already seen that. The moment aparoksha word comes, it is what? Self-evident. Anubhava sarupa atma, you cannot miss it. If this been taken very in detail, we have taken in the earlier. We have taken. Therefore, tattvamasi iti siddhavat upadesha. You are Brahma, tattvamasi mahavakya. You are means what? Already existing, not even going to produce yourself. That's why, and with anubhava swarupa, experience must be there. You can't say, kriya is not experience. Jnanam tu pramana janyam yatha bhuta vishaya. Any knowledge is born of what? Pramana. And is what? True to the entity to be known. Atma is anubhava swarupa, knowledge must be also what? Anubhava swarupa. Anubhava swarupa only. So I think this is enough as far as Atma is concerned. Let us now proceed where? To the Samadhi portion. Earlier, I had quoted from 9th chapter of Panchadashi, Dhyana Deepa. This is the place. Of course, then the means was, what was the means? Sadhana. Nirguna Brahma Jnana. Nirguna Brahma Jnana. That was the means together. But we are not concerned about the means. We are concerned about that. In that Nirvikalpa Samadhi, whatever vastu remains, that is, come on, tell me, what did I tell? Shodhitatvam padam. Means, literally, cleansed you. What do you mean by cleansed you? Nirupadhika you. Tatvam asi. Tvam, you is not your samsari you. It's a jiva. Free from all the upadis, Atma in its real nature. So that's what. And where is it available? In that Nirvikalpa Samadhi that was told. Now let us see more about this. Because some people say in Vedanta, Samadhi has no relevance. And at other time, when the things are hot, because they have to sit on the frying pan, they say, Vedanta accepts Samadhi as a means. Because Bhashyakara, they can't contradict the Bhashyakara. Means they are contradicting one place. See, I know from where that confusion has come. Moment Samadhi is said, they jump to Andha Samadhi. I am going to describe what that Andha Samadhi is, because this Andha Samadhi concept is Andha for many. Obscure for many. Do you know why? It is not available readily. You have to dig in the Yoga Vashishta. I will give you a reference so that you can do homework, okay? If you are in the habit. That's the habit. You should have a habit of this homework. says, now let us see what exactly is samadhi, or what is the state of that mind wherein shodhita tvampada is possible, and that is what swarupa pratishtha atma, atma is true nature, is available. Panchadashi chapter 1 verse 54, sabhyam vichikitse arthe chetasah sthapitasya yat ekatanatvam, ekatanatvam etadhi jididhyasanam uchyate dhyatru dhyana. Next one, 55, dhyatru dhyane parityajya kramat deyaika gocharam nivate deepavat chittam samadhi iti abhidiyat. First step, nididhyasana leading to samadhi. What is that first step? Say, tabhyam. Tabhyam. What is that? Tabhyam. Means of Shravana and Mana. Look, this dismisses Andha Samadhi. Andha Samadhi person has no Shravana Manana. Shravana Manana Abhyam. Yes. Nirvichikitse arthe is whatever you have ascertained of Shastra, which is free from vichikitsa, doubt. Means manana is thorough, all doubts are removed. Chetasaha sthapitasya, in that swarupa, your abidance of your mind, means anatma vritti pratyaya, anatma vritti pravaha removed, atma vritti pravaha supplemented. In the start the seer, ekatanatvam, ekatana means what? Steadiness or the abundance of the mind, ekagrata, single pointedness of the mind in the vastu, ascertained and freed from doubt. That is what is called as nididhyasanam. It is called as nididhyasanam. Same thing first, but here tributi is that I am doing meditation. Further, dhyatru dhyane parityajya, I am the meditator given up, means by intensity of the nididhyasana. Dhyana, the process of meditation, given up. Then what happens? Kramat. Kramat means by abhyasa. Repeated practice is necessary. Dheyaika gocharam bhavati. Antakarna becomes dheyaika. Atma swarupa only remains. Nothing is there. Like what? Nivata deepavat. Like a lamp, oil lamp, kept in a breezeless place. How steady it is. So the antakarna steady, absorbed where? In Atma Swarupa. That chittam is what? Samadhi iti abhidhiyat. One way of seeing, we'll see further next time and draw the contrast with Andha Samadhi. Problems are with Andha Samadhi, though experience of Nirvikalpa is same in the book. But is this Samadhi what I'm talking? Started with Ravana Manana, is called as, come on, what Samadhi? Viveka Prajna Samadhi. That distinction, you see next time.